Dear friends, the message of today's readings are direct and crystal clear. Hence, I would like to focus on the gospel, especially the process and persons in this healing of the blind man. There are four reasons why Pharisees condemned Jesus. First of all, the healing was done or took place on Sabbath. Secondly, healing is done through making a spittle, which they consider as a medical or using the medicine. Thirdly, he drew many disciples towards Jesus out of jealousy. Fourthly, the Jews refused the water of the pool of Siloam, and Jesus sends a blind man to Siloam. As opposed to these condemnations, listen to the man's gradual faith. This gradual faith is popularly known as miracle of faith or the spiritual sight. First, the blind man considers Jesus as a mere man, maybe a remarkable man. Secondly, as his faith grows, when Pharisees question the cured blind man, he says that Jesus is a prophet. From a mere man or a remarkable man, he becomes a prophet. Thirdly, and most importantly, the man says, "I believe God," and he worships him, and he falls on the knees of Jesus. So more than the gift of physical faith, the gift of faith on the spiritual side is very significant and most important, because Jesus became someone more deeply personal to this blind man. What is the similarity between this blind man and each one of us? When he was small, Jesus was an extraordinary man, someone special, a miracle worker or a miracle maker or wonder worker. As we mature, our faith also matured. Our perception of Jesus was much richer. Jesus became God's own beloved Son, the light of the world, the Savior of the world, and especially our own beloved friend. In our relationships, be it in marriage or religious life, the more and more we become aware of the person or we know the person intimately, the shortcomings, the negative side of the other person looms large. But the more and more we become aware of Jesus, the better and the best our lives will be. And this is the difference that we see, the similarity and the lesson that we see in today's gospel. Why? As the first reading spoke to us today, God looks into our hearts, not the external appearance. Or as the second reading revealed to us, Jesus invites each one of us to be the children of the light and not to be stuck in darkness or spiritual blindness and see the negative side, but rather be on the positive side. What do we learn from the readings of today? First, each one of us are called to be the children of light by knowing Jesus. The second lesson is, we need to look at things and people through the eyes and heart of God. Thirdly, our faith has to mature gradually through the understanding of Jesus. To know Jesus, we need to read his word and follow in his footsteps. Finally, each of us, like King David, are chosen and anointed through our baptism, and we need to renounce Satan in our lives and accept Jesus as our guru, as our personal friend. Dear friends, I conclude these reflections with a story and a poem that helps me these days as we are in the pain and gloom of Corona with stress and even distress. St. John Henry Cardinal Newman was a professor at Oxford University. When he was 32 years old, his health was very bad, and he took a break from his writes this poem. Lent bring delight amidst the encircling gloom. Lent down beyond. The night is dark and I am far from home. Lent down beyond. Keep thou my feet, I do not ask to see. The distant scene, one step enough for me. I was not ever thus, nor prayed that thou shouldst lead me on. I love to choose and see my path, but now lead thou me on. I love the garish day, and spite of fears, pride ruled my will. Remember not past years. So long thy power hath blessed me, sure it will lead me on. O'er moor and fen, o'er crag and torrent, till the night is gone, and with morn those angel faces smile, which I have loved so long since and lost a while. Meantime, long the narrow, rugged path thyself has trod, lead, Saviour, lead me home in childlike faith, home to my God, to rest forever after earthly strife in the